Visions of your new world are now coming into plain view as your people begin to climb over the last hill, and the horizon is now well within the sights of your eyes that long to see what it is that now fills the scenery like a picture postcard mailed to a loved one from your favorite vacation hideaway. We say warmly to all of you who have done even your small parts to make this day come true for all of you that your services to the light will never be forgotten, are never overlooked, and you are sincerely commended for taking the time, making the effort and doing just what it is you promised you would after you got here and after you began to shake off the cobwebs of forgetfulness and malaise. There are so very many of you who are here, your brothers and sisters who you may refer to as your light worker family, but there are not very many of you who have awakened to this revelation, to this knowledge. There are many of your brothers and sisters who yet remain in sleep, in slumber, in restful forgetfulness, as the veil for them has yet to be lifted from their eyes and their perceptions. What to do about this? We have convened in our meeting halls with many of our top thinkers and our most esteemed planners, and we have devised what we feel can act as some sort of solution to this problem that has presented itself. That's what we do here. We recognize obstacles and then we convene to search for a solution to this challenge, a key if you will, that will unlock this, the next door. We saw a challenge here and we were eager to rise up to it and defeat it. So this is the solution, although there are no guarantees, that we have come up with. We have decided to allow these souls to remain in their restful states, let us refer to it for now, and awaken them at what we have concluded is an appropriate time frame, at a time when perhaps their services are not even any longer required, but would still be very beneficial in many ways to our work here assisting this planet rise to their personal challenges. Challenges that may not exactly have anything to do with our mission. To explain this in greater detail to allow it to be understood clearer by you, let us suppose there are personal challenges that many of the inhabitants of this planet will face in the days ahead. These may be challenges that do not in many ways have anything to do with our itinerary or what our plans have been in service to this planet. Remember, we did not come here to do everything for the people of this world. After all, it is their world, it is their journey, and we do not kibitz or interfere when we are not thoroughly necessary. In other words, there are certain, what we shall refer to as personal challenges and goals that the inhabitants of this world have set out for themselves, and what we feel is the best approach is to allow these beings to swath their own path, to blaze their own trail and go it alone at least some part of the distance. That at least was our plan. Now, since there are so many light workers who have yet to awaken and have not fulfilled their incarnate contracts with themselves and with us, the Galactic Federation of Light, we feel we will give them a second opportunity to offer their services, whatever those services may be to others. This way they can return back home if this is what they wish after our work here is done, or return to their positions within our organization or within another organization that is also here, and they will be able to say that they at least worked for a certain period of time in service to others along the lines of their contracts. Do you understand what we have explained here? We feel we've been somewhat clear here and there is no reason to examine this any further. We would just like for you, our light workers that have awakened, to know that we have convened and we have reached a decision that may even involve you personally. For you see, there are those of you who are reading these words right now who have not at this time fulfilled your agreements with us, and you have not fulfilled the personal agreements you have made with yourself, for you see you have come here for more than one reason. Some of you have come here for two main reasons, and some of you even more so, and there are those of you who have not yet fulfilled these agreements. We would like to say to those of you who have yet to engage in activities or work that is related to your agreements that it is still not too late to get in the game and get the ball rolling. How to go about this, you may ask. Well, we will say again that you can never go wrong by helping prepare humanity for our introductions, which, although we have decided will not occur in any major announcements through current world governments, as we feel there are just too many of this world who are not yet prepared for what would be for them a shocking revelation, will take place on at least some level. We have other ways that we have planned that will allow at least all who wish to see through even the slightest bit of examination or inspection now positively without any doubt that we are here and are here not in a few ships and with a few personnel, but are here in quite large numbers. This is the plan, and this will allow those who do not wish to see the opportunity to continue on in their lives as if nothing along these lines has ever changed. In other words, there will be those who will be able to look another in the eye and say there's no one here. We are all alone, and if they wish to continue the dream that they are all alone in this entire universe then we say to them Godspeed, be proud, hold fast to your convictions and we will do nothing to wrestle you out of your dream state. This is the plan, and we feel that this plan will succeed as we see many of this world who have shown remarkable talent in seeing just what it is they wish to see. And on the other hand, not seeing anything they do not wish to see. The level of this talent on this particular planet would have to be, in many of our personal opinions, universal class. In other words, we would say that the people of Earth, the human being, has shown a remarkable talent far and above the abilities of all the other beings that we have met and we have worked with in this universe to block out any portions of their reality that does not please them. That they do not agree with, that they do not wish to experience, that they do not believe or resonate with or that they believe is an impossibility or even at some level just an improbability. Many of these individuals have shown a remarkable tenacity to argue away and throw away, block and obscure evidence that their perceptions of their reality may not be precisely the reality they are experiencing, but since reality does lie in the eye of the beholder, in a way you can say they are living. They are seeing, they are perceiving their precise surroundings, for they have found a way to adapt to all these changes and all this evidence and find some kind of magical way or some kind of academic way to dismiss it and dismiss it they have and dismiss it they will continue to do, whether or not our ships are coming and going and seawalls are being constructed and free energy devices are being distributed and all kinds of projects and programs are sprouting up all over your planet and the entire face of your globe is changing remarkably, dramatically, quickly, and your scenery is altering into what looks more like a beautiful picturesque and futuresque vision of some of your most imaginative science fiction writers. They will find a way to dismiss all this and give credit to your governments, or to some secret agencies, or to the work of mad scientists, or artists, or that it is all a hoax or a charade or some kind of reality television program. Yes, this is what these individuals will say. Our monitoring services have concluded this, though conclusions may not always be realized in the way they are theorized. But nonetheless our scientists and researchers and some of our top thinkers believe this is just what will occur here. There will be splits of reality, of personal perceptions, of opinion, of viewpoint, just as there are today. Nothing will really change, although the level of this split will change between those of you who are seeing for yourselves and living for yourselves higher dimensional aspects of existence. And those who may even be family or friends or are even a spouse who are living a lower dimensional reality. Do you understand what we are hinting at here? Because again, some of you see what others do not and vice versa at any given moment, even while reading the same words or looking at the same object or witnessing the same event. What we have done here is we have issued you a hint, a clue. No matter what level of a hint or clue you perceive with your eyes and your mind that is unique to you and to no one else. We have issued you this hint, for we feel there are so very many of you who have asked the same question, and there are those of you who are very intuitive and you are figuring out precisely what this question is at this very moment, while there are others of you who will not be able to figure this out, at least at this moment while you are reading these words. And there are others of you who are not even trying to figure out, who perhaps do not want to figure out, who perhaps do not feel any motivation to figure out what question this hint will help you answer. We will not divulge what this question is, but we will remind you that it is possibly the most often spoken question that we have been asked and that you have asked one another and you have asked yourselves throughout all of this recent period in your history. This is all we have for you today, dear ones. We are very well on schedule in regards to the messages we would like to share with you, and we do not have to share with you very lengthy messages each day to keep on pace. Instead, we will just stay on our schedule as we have planned and share with you what we feel is the relevant bits and pieces of the greater puzzle that will be entirely pieced together for you before the end of this period in your history, before the last page of this chapter is turned, for you are reaching these last pages right now. There are not many more to turn, and when the last page is turned, this entire story that you have been such an essential, important and precious part of will be revealed, and all the characters and the events, the plot twists, antagonists, allies, lovers, mystery, suspense and incredible climax will all be resolved and become crystal clear to you as you close the covers of the book of your journey here. We are your fellow authors with pen in hand of the Galactic Federation of Light.